today's topic is the third eye, the sixth center. I am talking about the Kundalini. It is a life force. It is the force we live on. We are alive. I talked about 5 chakras. In the Western Hemisphere, they call it center, but it is not a center. It is a chakra. Chakra means wheel. The energy moves like a wheel moves. Basically, the chakra, they don't exist. But wherever you feel that energy moving, that's what we call the chakra. Chakra moves, the energy moves in a wheel, like a chakra, like a wheel. So basically, you cannot take the picture of the chakras like Muladhara or Swadhisthana or Manipura or the Anahat or Vishuddhi. Now today is Ajna Chakra. I suggested you keep your energy a lot, because without energy you will not be making your energy move towards higher consciousness, upward. Energy moves upward only if you are positive, good thinking, and you have tremendous energy. If you are lacking energy, it means you need to create energy. Be healthy first. Work on yourself, on your physical aspect, and then your mental aspect. Then you can do further. Okay, I told you 5th chakra was very important, Vishuddhi chakra. Vishuddhi means purify. You purify yourself. And today's chakra, what I am talking about, it is called Ajna Chakra, Ajna Chakra. It is also called by third eye. It is the hidden eye. And people try to concentrate. When they close their eyes, they try to look at the center part of the forehead. Even though we have two eyes, we can look at outside. But this eye, this chakra, which is called Ajna Chakra. Ajna means the wisdom center. It is really the wisdom center. And more you go deep and deep and deeper by closing your eyes, you will be surprised that you begin to see a lot of things. Many secrets begin to reveal to you. They become unfolded for you. You begin to sink into unknown, and unknown begin to be known. That's why when you concentrate on that part of the chakra, the third eye, the center part of your forehead, rather between the eyebrows, that's what it is. It is very important. You can start contemplating there. It is called contemplation or concentration. But don't be confused. Contemplation is a step towards meditation. People think when they concentrate on this chakra, they are automatically in meditation. It is not. It is still contemplation. But it is a step towards meditation. Contemplation is like you are gazing in the mirror, and mirror is reflecting something. That is called contemplation. You are concentrating on something. Mirror is mirroring something. But in meditation, mirror is there, but there is no anything in it. No, mirror doesn't mirror anything further. So when there is a contemplation, you can, by imagination or by looking something, you can concentrate on something. Like you see yourself in the mirror. There is something to look at. That is contemplation. It's not meditation. In meditation, just you, just be, your being, there is nothing left, no thoughts. But you need practice for that. So concentrate on this third eye. It is a very powerful center in the body. If the energy doesn't move in this center, it means person feels very lazy, person feels very not intellectual level. So if this chakra is opened up, so you become very wise, very intelligent. It is intellectual center actually. The more you concentrate here, let me tell you, many people, they try to open it by yoga postures. And many yogis, they suggest that why don't you learn headstand postures, like stand on your head. It is very dangerous posture, because in the head, there is a top of the head, what I will talk about, the last chakra, Sahasrara chakra, top of the head. Or also there is a brain. Brain controls the whole body. And brain, when you are someone, stand on the head, all the blood from the body rushes towards the brain. And brain has billions, billions of blood vessels. Can you imagine that it is a little small brain, and they cannot tolerate those little tiny blood vessels, like 1,000 times thinner than your one hair. Is that small? So they cannot tolerate the flood of the blood which is rushing from all over from the body you are standing. I will suggest you, if you want to do this headstand to clear up your this chakra, you just stay maybe 30 seconds and you just again come to the same position, you stand up on your feet. So that might helpful, but don't do it without guidance. When they do this posture, they can harm themselves. The brain vessels, the blood vessels will be damaged and the brain cannot function, and you are blocking your wisdom. So the postures, you need to do it under guidance. And it is very difficult. Many yogis, they don't do what is the right way to do it. So if you have this kind of question, you can ask me and I will explain to you. Anyway, this is third eye is very important. When you concentrate, even you concentrate, you can concentrate like a light or a blue color or a, whatever you like. Or you can gaze to the candle flame. So this way, this going to help you to seize your thoughts. The thoughts will not bother you when you concentrate. But don't think that is meditation. People think this is meditation, this is contemplation. You are concentrating on something that is called contemplation. But at least your thoughts are begin to flow in one direction, on one thing. That is a big achievement. With this technique, you are able to create a lot of miracles. Miracle can happen. Because when somebody is really focusing on this center creates a lot of miracles. Miracle is from you. But you need to. Once you are there, you will not even see, you cannot even imagine how many minutes you can stay there, or sometimes hours. You never know. So try this, practice it. Concentrate there. Whatever you see there, light or anything, or any object, that is fine. This is contemplation. But time will come, you will be in meditation. So this is the symptoms of this. When it is working, then your whole channels are open. Your body is very healthy. Your mind is very healthy. the negative thoughts that they don't attack on you, you mostly be positive that time. You are positive most of time when this chakra works. So you need to understand those are the symptoms. And you have more clarity. You can work very well. You don't get tired. Even you are reading hours and hours and hours, writing hours and hours, speaking hours and hours. This is like unending, never-ending knowledge. It is so much knowledge there. So this is the chakra. You need to activate it slowly by practicing this.